It was several years ago when I was walking through my local big box store and noticed the new Briggs and Stratton engines. The new designs were overhead valve engines and also had a different style of carb made out of plastic. Now, why would you get rid of something that was almost unbeatable to change over to something new? What was so wrong with the old Flathead design that would make a long-lived company do something so foolish? In today's video, we look at this yard machine's mower, and the problem is that it won't start after a long winter storage. Now, I've already fixed this mower, and if you want to see that video, there should be a link to it at the top of the screen or at the end of this video. I'm just going to use this video as background while I talk about one of the biggest gambles Briggs has ever taken in a long time, which is to get rid of their bulletproof flathead engines. Now, the older engines could be put through the worst abuse and still run, which could have given you plenty of time to finally notice the issue and hopefully do something about it. Now, to prove my point, I found this battered old Briggs on a Poland mower, and besides it looking like it came from a dig site and with very little oil in the crankcase and in desperate need of an oil change, it still had enough compression to start, even lasting long enough that the deck cracked before the engine did. Luckily, this one doesn't look as bad as the other one, but looks can be very deceiving. I don't recall all the details for this mower, but I believe it ran the year before and was put away with gasoline in the tank. And after 5 months of storage, it doesn't want to start. Now, even though fuel is considered fresh for about 30 days, it begins to lose its punch after those 30 days. Of course, it doesn't mean that you can't use it on day 31, but just be aware that as more time goes by, it will make starting an engine with a carb a bit harder. Now, if you have electronic fuel injection like on a vehicle, it doesn't seem to be as affected by old gasoline. Unfortunately, this engine's plastic carb isn't going to help it to start, which is one of the biggest criticisms of the newer design. However, if this had fuel injection on it, this wouldn't be that big of an issue. We'll get more into that here in a little bit. So the old design was a flathead design, which has been around for a very long time, and there's a very good reason why. It's simple, which means it's reliable, has fewer parts, and is cheaper to make. The biggest benefit, at least for me, is that it doesn't have an issue with gasoline that's several months old. That means it's more likely to start even when the fuel has some age to it. Now, the biggest disadvantage to the flathead engine is of course the design of the combustion chamber, which causes it to have high emissions of hydrocarbons, which is a big no-no in today's world. I hate to say it, but the advantages of the old design, at least in my mind, is now the disadvantages for the new design, but in the opposite way. It's not as simple anymore, which means it's not as reliable, they're not as cheap to make either, and unfortunately it's now become very sensitive to the octane levels in the gasoline. So if your gasoline is several months old, it might be tough to start the engine, but you might not be able to get it started even if you put fresh gasoline in the tank and even in the carb. If you weren't aware of it, the fuel jet in these plastic carbs are so small, they have a tendency to clog if you leave them alone for more than a few months, which is more than likely the reason why this one isn't starting. As you can see, this gasoline looks very fresh, so if I had to guess, I think they put this gasoline into the tank only a few days ago in hopes they were going to use it, but the old gasoline had already damaged the carb. That means we'll need to take it apart and clear the jet. So the biggest reason I can think of why Briggs stopped the flathead engine and moved on to the more powerful, more efficient, cleaner burning, and I have to admit, quieter overhead valve, wasn't just an emissions issue. My belief is that they wanted to be more competitive in the marketplace. Now, I have no proof, of course, this is just my guess, but I wasn't able to find any information about why. Now, the design of the old flathead may have worked if you wanted to keep making low revving engines with low power numbers for very little money, but when your competitors like Kohler, Honda, and a large number of overseas engine makers were all making good power from smaller displacement engines and were more affordable, that must have been their sign to ditch the old design and make a new engine comparable to what was in the marketplace. Now, the cost of research and development for a mostly new engine must have been very expensive, so my idea would have been, instead of making a new engine, would have been to improve the old engine, and the way I would have done it would have been to make more power and less emissions by making the old engine have fuel injection. Now, carbs work well to deliver fuel to the engine, but to do it more efficiently, I would have designed a new carb, but with a simple fuel injector, pump, and a regulator all in one package. I could already hear the mechanics groaning about the idea of the old throttle body injection systems from years ago, but we've come a long way in technology since then. Yes, there would need to be a battery charging system and of course a small and simple ECU to control it. Now, some would say this is too complex to put on a lawnmower that costs around $250 and up, but I can't see how this would be more expensive or more complicated than redesigning a whole new engine. But for those of you who weren't aware of it, Briggs already had an overhead valve engine while the Flathead was still around. It was their dreaded in-tech engines. It even hurts me to mention those engines. I think the reason you didn't see them was because they put them on higher priced mowers like John Deere or the Troy built XP series. Now, the problem was that they had a lot of issues and most people just didn't like them. If Briggs really wanted to save some research money, they should have refined the in-tech engines, but instead came up with a brand new one, and the reason was simple, to save even more money. Redesigning a brand new engine gave them the opportunity to find ways to streamline their manufacturing process, cutting costs and increasing their profits, and to tell you the truth, it was a good strategy. The new engines, even though they were an overhead valve design, cost them less to make and would have made them a lot of money. That was until a few years ago when things kind of got tough for them. I know there's going to be some talk about mismanagement and poor leadership and also some labor issues, but that's after the fact and a different discussion altogether. I'm more worried about the part I can see in front of me, which is this new redesigned engine. I'll be honest, I kind of like it. I think it's a good engine with great power and it's even easier to work on thanks to their streamlining of the manufacturing process. It's made fixing it a whole lot easier. The problem is that there's a lot of fixing going on now. I haven't mentioned the other issues with this engine. There seems to be more issues with the recoil than the last design, and also this is when they started making it harder to do the oil changes by getting rid of the drain plugs. This was part of their sales gimmick, which was to make it easier to own by telling owners they didn't need to do any sort of maintenance on them, and I hate to say it, most went right along with it. Now, I don't want to be too hard on the company. They've given us a very good product for the last couple of decades, and I've learned a lot after working on them. I just wish they didn't get rid of the old engines and just made the changes they needed to make it more competitive without a full redesign. I mentioned how the new engines were supposedly cheaper than the older engines, and you might be wondering how I know that. The answer is I don't, but the reason I say that is because of a few reasons. First is the use of less metal parts and more plastics, which cost less to make. The second is the use of less fasteners. Everyone saved is less money for parts. And the last one is that the new engines are much lighter than the older ones. Less metal, less shipping weight equals less money to transport. After getting the carb off the engine and draining the fuel out of the bowl and cleaning the fuel jet, we finally put the carb back together and reinstalled it back onto the engine. Now, I didn't show it, but I put the fuel I drained out from the tank back into it since I was pretty certain it was still good. Now, at this point, we're now ready to try and start it. So does that mean I'm going to stop buying Briggs and Stratton engines? Not at all. I'm going to keep buying them, using them, and apparently fixing them for quite some time. That is, unless something more unfortunate happens to them in the next few years. So my question is, do you prefer to use the older flathead engines or the newer overhead valve engines? Now personally, I don't have a preference as far as using them, but if I had to own it and also use it, I would say the older engines, and the reason is because I feel like they're a better quality product. Now, I do feel as though the lighter engines make the new mowers easier to use. However, it also makes it feel more like a kid's toy and not a serious yard tool. Thank you for watching. I really do appreciate your time here. Please feel free to ask me any questions about this project or your own projects, and I hope to see you in the next video.